So what Martin then does is express these steps using a UML collaboration diagram. Recall that a collaboration diagram was like an object diagram, but the lines between the objects indicated operations, and the lines were numbered indicating the order of the operations. So in this case, we had the steps of the user interface, getting the request from the user with the brew button, and then asking the hot water source for whether it's ready, and then asking the containment vessel whether it's ready, and then starting the hot water source, heating up the water. So there's three steps labeled 1, 2, and 3 here, and we can see that there ought to be at least three classes supported to deal with those three possibilities.
Is it possible here for this diagram to be more descriptive in the sense that it seems like when you ask the hot water source, is it ready or not? If it says it is ready, then you might make the next check to see if the containment vessel is ready. But if it says no, it seems like a whole other set of steps may have to be taken to indicate to the user, hey, the water, hot water source, not ready to go.
Okay, so remember that a use case or a representation of a use case in a collaboration diagram or a sequence diagram is not contingent. Okay, it's one step-by-step walk through the system. And what we're going to have to do is to deal with contingencies, which are obviously an important part of this whole process, we're going to have multiple diagrams. And one of the things that Martin does is suggest that we can add together those diagrams. So I think that maybe is where you're going. We want to have them all there, but we'll do them a step at a time, so to speak.
So we would have, I guess, a use case then for user presses brew button and the water vessel is not ready. Like that would be a separate use case, so we could model that and
right.
then tie that in later with this situation, which seems like we're pressing brew and everything's ready to go.
That's where we're going.
Okay.